Hi friends, today it's put Plutarch Heavensbee from The Hunger Games into the spotlight. Plutarch Heavensbee is the head game maker of the 75th Hunger Games, who actually turns out to be a key player in the Rebel Alliance that overturns Panem.
This is Plutarch Heavensbee, head game maker.
Plutarch was named for Lucius Mestrius Plutarchus, known as Plutarch. Plutarchus was a known biographer and essayist who was most known for the fact that he could balance both the positive and the negative of anything he was writing about. This included some of the people he wrote biographies about. He could talk about all the amazing things that they have achieved and they stand for, and all the terrible things they have done.
It's moves and counter moves. That's all we gotta look at.
This is a quality that the character Plutarch actually still has. He's able to analyze and balance all the positives and negatives around him. Be it an event or a person, he's able to see their true colors and then use this knowledge to his advantage.
This is the only choice you have. People don't always show up the way you want them to, Madam President.
His surname, Heavensbee, is a mashup of two words, heaven and bee. I know that seems pretty obvious, but let's look into these words and what they mean and how they can relate to this character. The fact that his surname has heaven in it shows that Plutarch is probably more virtuous than he at first seems.
Still, if you abandon your moral judgment, it can be fun.
The bee aspect of his name symbolizes that he is hardworking and can rise to the top if he chooses to. There are quite a few differences in Plutarch's character between the books and the movies. In the books, we first meet Plutarch in the first book, The Hunger Games, during Katniss's private training session. Katniss gets frustrated with the game makers who are more focused on the food around them than on watching her. She decides to shoot at an arrow in a pig's mouth to send them a message. In doing so, she understandably shocks a lot of the game makers. One of these game makers is Plutarch, who backs away and trips, and he ends up falling into the bowl of punch. Plutarch wasn't present at all in the first movie. His first on-screen appearance is in Catching Fire, which is the second movie.
Well, maybe it was you who inspired me to come back.
This is likely due to the fact that the director decided to not add in a character in the first movie who had no influence on the story. During the events of the last book, Katniss's prep team are discovered in horrible condition in a cell in District 13. Plutarch immediately decides to take control of the situation. He gets them out of the cell and gets them the physical and mental support that they need to survive this traumatic event. And I'm not just talking about being beaten and locked in the cell, I'm also talking about the fact that these people were taken from their home, the only place they've ever known, and brought literally into the enemy's camps. This entire interaction doesn't exist in the movies, because in the movies, Katniss's prep team don't really exist much. We do see glimpses of them, but they're not actual characters like they are in the books.
What's that?
We're just saying we might need to hose you down again before we take you to Cinna.
They are replaced in the Mockingjay movies by Effie Trinket. Though she's not beaten or locked up in a cell, she still struggles with accepting her new life in District 13. Plutarch plays a big role in helping her adjust to this new world.
You're not a prisoner? You're free to join the rest of 13.
Not looking like this. Thank you very much.
We have a bigger issue than wardrobe, Miss Trinket.
Another big difference in the Mockingjay book compared to the movies is when Katniss, Gale, and her camera crew go into District 8.
You're alive then? We weren't sure.
Katniss, Commander Paler, District 8.
In the book, Plutarch actually accompanies them. He does his best to protect Katniss during the bombings and the attack on the citizens. However, in the movie, Plutarch remained in District 13 with President Coyne.
Let's see what you can do. Be careful.
Philip Seymour Hoffman was the actor who played Plutarch. Unfortunately, he passed away on February 2nd, 2014, before he had a chance to finish filming all of his scenes for Mockingjay Part 2. Thankfully, he had actually been able to film the majority of his big scenes, except for one. Right at the end of the story, just after Katniss has killed President Coyne, Plutarch was supposed to come and talk to her. We see this in the books. He has a beautiful speech about people and war and how we never seem to learn from our mistakes.
The war's over. We'll enter that sweet period where everyone agrees not to repeat the recent horrors.
Understandably, this is going to be a very emotional scene where the audience finally gets to see Plutarch's true colours. A lot of the cast and crew have talked about how Seymour Hoffman was very excited for filming this scene. He had loads of ideas of how he wanted to say the lines and the facial expressions he was going to have. Unfortunately though, as I said, he passed away before he was able to do any of this. Woody Harrelson, who plays Haymitch, had to take over Plutarch's role for this scene. The screenwriters and directors decided to have Haymitch read a letter to Katniss that was written by Plutarch.
Well, Plutarch gave me a letter for you.
I don't want it.
You never make it easy, do you?
Obviously, this version of the scene doesn't have the amount of feeling and depth to it that it would have had Plutarch been able to talk to Katniss directly. There were other smaller, much more minor moments that Philip Seymour Hoffman was unable to film. For these tiny snippets, the lines that he had were given to other characters. It was also decided to use CGI animation to add Plutarch in digitally into the background of these scenes. You can see, for example, in this scene that if you actually watch Plutarch while the other characters are moving around and talking, he doesn't quite look natural. At a glimpse, yes, he's completely normal, but if you actually watch him, he doesn't feel human. This is one of these scenes where CGI was used to add the character in post-production. Would you have liked to see Plutarch Heavensbee in the first movie? Please tell me in the comment section down below. And until next time, happy bubbles! Thanks so much for watching this video, and thank you to my Patreon bubblers for supporting the channel. If you want to see any of my other Hunger Games videos, you can click on the box on the left to find out quite a few facts about Coin, or you can click on the box on the right to find out if Plutarch was a rebel or a loyalist first. Thank you for liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and hitting that notification bell so you don't miss any future videos.